Law schools have lots of important goals, but one of the most important to me, and one of the most important to the student stakeholders, is creating graduates who are ready to represent clients and practice law.
Good lawyers write in a very understandable, clear, concise way. And it's a learned skill. It's a technique. And it has to be taught at the law school level. It's very hard for us to teach lawyers how to write in the heat of our practice.
In undergrad, they teach you to just write. Write as much as you can. Coming to law school, I think the transition into writing short sentences, but that get right to the point, was a struggle at the beginning. But now, after 3 years, I can say that I've gotten pretty good at it.
There was a study by the Carnegie Foundation and a simultaneous study published in Best Practices for Legal Education. And both of these concluded that law schools were not doing the job that they should be doing for students. Along with other schools, SUNY Buffalo went out and said, how can we do better?
Well, we did a lot of research into other legal research and writing programs across the nation, focusing in particular on the best programs, and we also spent a great deal of time interviewing local practitioners. And what emerged from that research, from the focus groups, was what is ultimately a 5-semester program, 3 semesters of which are taught by lawyer instructors.
I think the most important thing I learned in legal writing was how to think like a lawyer. I think that's the one class in law school that really teaches you how to make legal arguments, how to write briefs, and how to use them in practical ways.
The way I structure my class is we start with the very basic fundamental skills of understanding what goes into a clean English sentence. The assignments grow in complexity from a simple brief in the beginning to by the end of the first semester, they're actually writing what we call an objective memorandum.
I learned to really cut down my writing, use smaller words, learn to be punchy, and to address a very precise legal question that was asked.
Know your facts, do your research, don't make assumptions. You need to base everything you say and everything you write on the law and on the cases.
The most significant critique comes in, and where the best critique that I find comes in, is when we meet individually with the students and go over their memoranda or their motions or whatever they're working on. We go over them line by line.
A quality and in-depth research and writing program is critical to a legal education these days. The law schools staffed it with very good professors and people who are dedicated to it, and it shows.
I participated in the Frederick Douglass Moot Court competition. Both the oral skills and the writing skills that were attained in legal research and writing prepared me for that. We had to present a brief and we also had to do oral arguments, so I definitely felt prepared.
My first 2 summers, I worked at a bigger law firm in Cleveland, Ohio. And the first day I got there, I was asked to write a memo, a 15-page memo-ish on a breach of contract. And the first thing I did was I took out all of my old memos and handouts from my legal research and writing professor, Laura Riley, and that guided me through my first assignment.
This is a program that committed itself to excellence at the very beginning and is committed to increasing excellence, is committed to analyzing how every semester it can do what it's doing even better.
Legal writing definitely prepared me for practice because in the last week, I've already had to write client letters, memos for my boss, and a few motions for the court. I would not have been able to do that without legal research and writing.
Our students, the students from SUNY Buffalo, now have the skills they need to succeed in today's legal marketplace.